have always existed. In fact, the further you go back into history, the more there were long-distance relationships. Travel was very slow, communications were very poor. So once a person, a friend, a family member, a spouse, leaves and goes away outside the town, they would just not be available at all. I was told when my father went to USA on a United Nations fellowship, when he left home, on the 42nd day, my mother got an aerogram from him saying, "I have reached safely here." For 42 days, she did not know where he is. And then he used to call up, I'm told, once in 3 months. After he completed his fellowship in 2 years, he came back, and that was the time when they met after about 2 years and 2 months. So these things are common. Military people, for example, 10 months, 11 months of the year, they were not only out, they were incommunicative, because in the front areas and all that, there was nothing, you know. Even in our days, for example, those of you who are old enough will recall making a trunk call, or later on even making an SDD or ISD call used to be very expensive. So even though the facilities started coming in, we could not communicate. Now what has happened? Communication and transport both have become easy. People who live far away from their loved ones or whatever it is, catch a weekend flight, come spend 1 or 2 days and they are back. Same way, phones, now that, you know, unlimited calls have become free. People just keep chatting and calling up, starting from a boyfriend, girlfriend who are in love and who are in different cities or different countries, going on to married partners, going on to parent, child. The father is in another city or even another country. He calls up to check whether his son has done the homework or not. So that is where the difference has come in. That is the reason why I took up this topic of talking about how do you handle long distance relationships in today's electronic era. One thing that I've seen is we are overusing the phone just because it is free. People are talking constantly on the phone when they are not together, so much so that sometimes when they are living under the same roof also, they have stopped understanding how to talk. They go out and send messages and stuff like that. There is something really, you know, going wrong. Today's, I think 2 weeks back, there was a very good media report by Dr. Vivek Murthy, who is the Surgeon General of USA, how he mentioned that the social media is affecting children's mental health and things like that. But that is the only way that, you know, people think that they can keep connected. They don't even know that there are other ways and means of being connected. A military officer friend of mine used to say that once work is over in a non-family station where only the officers are, the men are there, in the evening they used to all get together, play games, have a drink together, play music in the hall where they are sitting, and thereby the bonding used to take place. He says today's young officers, the moment their work is over, they disappear into their rooms and are on their mobiles. Small things, but this is what is affecting. In a lighter way, also tell you that there was a time when an officer told his commandant that I need to go back home because my wife is not well, please grant me leave. The commandant did not want to give leave, but when he said that my wife is not well, he said go quickly, you know, do whatever is the needful and come back. He did it and he came back. A month later, his wife came to visit the station and the commandant asked her, "Ma'am, how is your health?" She said, "My health is okay. Why?" "No, last month I granted him special leave just to come and meet you." She said, "Last month he never came home." Now you can form your own presumptions of what is happening. So these changes that have come into the you know, people who are away from their families, away from their partner, or away from their children, even elderly parents for that matter, when they are away from them, what does it mean? We have so many, many families today who have given an excellent education to their children and the children have gone abroad. Maybe initially for higher studies, But then they decided to stay back. Maybe they got married and they are settled over there. How is it impacting the senior citizens who are now left alone? And more so as the number of children keep reducing. When people had 2, 4, 6 children, even if one or two, you know, were away, they could manage with the rest. There was this quote, you know, which said that absence makes the heart grow fonder. That doesn't apply anymore. The way things are going and the way communication has become easier, the physical distance seems to have taken a meaning of its own. I was also told that there was a research which said that 40% of close relationships do not survive a long period of being away from each other. And I'm not only talking about man-woman relationship. I know of children who have really started having behavioral issues because one parent has been away for long periods of time. And even when that parent comes, he or she is very busy catching up with so many things that the parent cannot give quality time to the child. So what it boils down to is, how well, how close are you connecting emotionally through electronic media? And that is not at all easy. It is very, very difficult unless you plan. So anybody planning to have a long distance relationship, in the sense that you are not going to be in the same city or even in the same country, how are you going to maintain the emotional aspect of your communication? As I keep telling always, there are 4 pillars to close relationships, particularly marital and all that. One of them is communication. The other is respect, respecting the difference. The third is trust, and the fourth is commitment. If these 4 are taken over and developed and built, then even a long distance relationship can survive. In this case, I would like to add a 5th one, and that is touch. And touch plays a very important role. We don't even realize it. So when the person is away, then what happens? There is no touch. How do you overcome that? Lack of physical intimacy, lack of the warmth of having somebody close to you. These are the major challenges that are being faced. I have asked Purnima and Sonal to give you a few examples based on the counseling that we have been doing for so many years, which drives home this point. And then I have made a slide of a few practical tips on how to ensure that your long distance relationship remains healthy. So over to Purnima.
Yes, good afternoon. Yeah, so we thought that, you know, being under the doing a lot of counseling and meeting so many different people, and more so nowadays, we get this opportunity of meeting people where either the child or the spouse or the romantic partner is away, or the sibling is away. So considering all those things, we thought we'll also share our 2 pence with you, our learnings with you, our experiences with you, so that we also kind of understand what all are the distinguishing features, the distinguishing points in the long distance relationships. And a good afternoon and a hi to all of you all. It's only my pleasure to be there with you all and just share a few of my own experiences. So we were just thinking that, you know, let's look at it how it was earlier. And many of y'all may, you know, vouch for it, that much, much earlier, when your father or your grandparent was abroad, and that could be even either abroad or it could also be in a far off place in the same country. So what would happen is that we would all write, if they are in India, we would write those small with small handwriting inland letters. And the handwriting would be so small that he may possibly need a, you know, what do you call that, lenses to read what's under it. But everybody wanted to write at least two lines, three lines, and the Ali's taking it a little on the other side. Distance actually made it fonder for us, because whenever there was, we would wait for the dakia or the postman to come and give us the letter. And if a letter doesn't come for a few days, not that we would panic, but we would, you know, kind of look forward to that. And if there was a festival, we would go to Archie's, buy different cards, and then send it to grandpa or to papa. And he would get some exclusive, unique gifts from there, right? And it would be like the speciality of that place, which we would not get in our city. That was then. So, and if he's abroad, then even those simple choti-choti chocolates which they would buy for us would be what a treat. We would savor it. We would keep it, hide it in a place that nobody knows. And we would keep, we'll not bite it and eat it off. You just roll it in your tongue, that ice cream, or I mean, sorry, that chocolate. You roll it, and something that you would get from abroad. And at that time, for abroad, there used to be those aerograms. So again, we would use every part of that aerogram to write something, sweet nothings to our loved one over there. That was then that I'm talking of. I also remember doing one thing, that we would have those envelopes in which you could write down and send. That would be a little more expensive. So we would get thin, those paper napkins, and very lightly the whole family, like those tracing papers, the whole family would write on that and make the weight so light so that it is the same cost. And any item that comes in from there would be savored so well with so much of love and affection. Well, yes, that was then. And if we just have a little deco into what it is now. So now, to a larger extent, what happens is that, yeah, I'll just tell you a little more. At that time, whenever Tata or Appa used to come, we used to have stories to listen to. He would take us to a park. He would sit down in at home after dinner. He would tell us all stories about that place. So let's look at it how it is now. Now you find that many a times we are in touch, thanks to social media, to video calling, and to WhatsApp calling, which is free. We are in touch with them on a day-to-day basis. So, well, in some cases, there's also a little bit of remote controlling which happens when the parents or the spouse will ask, where are you going? What is your program today? Why are you late? And I called you, you didn't pick up. And if 2-3 WhatsApp calls go and the child doesn't pick up, our heartbeats are more, our blood pressure slowly seems to be spiking up. Recipes happen then and there. So I tell my sunny boy or my daughter that, okay, cut onions, no, slice it like this, slice it like that. And everything happens then and there. And to a large extent, I think with the mall culture coming in, more so in the metro cities, we find that it's not that anything is very unique or rare. Chocolate, you say, ah, you get it here. Some clothes, you say, oh, you get it in this mall. Or if you want some specific item, even refrigerators, they would pay customs duty and it used to come through sea. No, that was the time that it was. Now, unless something is totally unique or it's very rare, only then that people really cherish the little things. And after they have come back, we find that memories are not that so much to share. You know na that person, you know na this person, because we know it all. And we have mothers or relatives who on a day-to-day basis do come to know that, okay, you are going to college today, you are going to school today, you are having a project today. It's mobiles have reduced the distance, which is good also in a way. But when we, Ali also just mentioned, and we would also want to tell you that what is the impact of using phones in these long distance relationships? So we will be doing it on the other half of the break. Yes, transportation, communication, visas have become so easy to get reasonably. unless it's the few certain what do you say, prestigious, luxurious countries, that visa takes little longer time. But otherwise, visas are reasonably so easy for us to get. And hence, if one person is in Egypt and if the other person is in India, the converging point becomes Dubai or London or maybe some country where they will all meet up and have a family gathering. Distances have reduced considerably between countries. So thanks to, yes, of course, phone, thanks to the easy visas which you get, thanks to booking your flight tickets much in advance, right? Earlier, it was not like that. You have to stand in the queue, wait for the train. Even if it is some city which is a little away, you knew that you have to spend 2 nights in the train. You carry so much of food and water and clothes and everything and go. It is not so now. Within 2.5 hours, you are directly over there. And yes, Bunny is playing a major role. That is, kids can get hardly cherish small things. I true that. That, yes, of course, has happened because of the globalization also, na, Navya Shri. So, one thing, you know, where Ali was mentioning about if you are absent from a person, our hearts would grow fonder. Let me just share one particular experience which I had with a counselee. So there was this very young girl. She was in a relationship with a boy in her own office. So they both were moving along well, getting along well, that they also started living together to share rent and things like that, to have a common living. So this boy got transferred to another city, which was quite far away. Traveling by flight, of course, yes, but it would take more than half or three-fourths day for her to reach that place. So what happened is that because she was so used to him on a day-to-day basis, she would miss him badly. So what she ended up doing was she would take a flight on Friday night, reach there on Saturday early morning or something like that. He would come to pick her up. And right from early morning to 2:33, they would be together. Then Monday, she would take the first flight, first thing in the morning, directly dash to her office. So that is how it used to happen. After some time, she knew that they could not meet so often. But because, digressing a little on the importance of touch, feel, a hug, a nice handshake, this girl started missing all these things so badly. And of course, she started missing his company also to a very large extent. So what happened was, without her realizing, and because of the need of her being wanting to be close to someone else, made her get into another relationship. And well, as this thing goes, after a while, he came back to the same city, and both the boys and the girls were all over there, and she was in a total dichotomy. What to do now? Am I cheating on him? Am I feeling guilty? So instant gratification has become a very important thing of the day. You know, the touch and feel, I think, is such a marvelous thing. Just imagine that, you know, you're having a very bad cold and a running nose, and you're sneezing away to glory. And then your mama kind of, you know, ruffles your hair, gives you some hot kashaya or some hot soup. And then she applies Vicks on your feet, and then she puts socks for you. I think more than the medicine, all these things make you feel much better, which actually plays an important role in missing out in long distance relationships. And how to go about doing this, in our PPT presentation, we'll be taking you through that process also. Another thing that could possibly happen in certain cases is that if a person, you know, has a little bit of a low self-esteem, not really very self-aware, then a long distance relationship could possibly to a very large extent lead to some kind of a insecurity also. So somewhere, you know, it kind of bites into you that your confidence becomes wobbly. You start thinking that oh, will he be cheating on me, or am I good enough for him to come back? Or the mother may think that, what if my sunny boy gets married to some girl over there, and he doesn't listen to my choices? So all these things also, which is insecurity, being a little, having a little bit of low self-esteem, could mean a lot in these kind of long distance relationships. This is from my side, my two pens, and now we'll have the PPT so that while you read the points, we can quickly have an interactive session with you.
Yes, as in today's world, long distance relationship has become part of many people's life, right? So here are a few tips which you can use to make your long distance relationship work. So use technology wisely. Now, as technology is so freely available, when you are having some kind of, you know, if you are missing that person, or, you know, I would say rather have a routine. If that person was with me, what all I would do, starting from waking up. Now, you can't go physically shake that person and say, hey, wake up, it's time. But you can definitely send a good morning wish, which has a tone. The other person also keeps a tone on that. So understand that, okay, mama is waking me up, or my girlfriend is waking me up. That tone, that tune, that notification sound gives you a hint that, okay, she is waking me up, right? Like that, even when you are, get back to the same. Even when, you know, if it's a grandchild and a grandmother, telling stories, bedtime stories can be in your timetable. Morning and evening are those most precious moments where you want to be with your loved ones. Days goes, you know, in your work or you're doing your routine, right? At the same time, make sure you don't spend too much time on the phone also. Now, when we say don't spend too much time on the phone, means if you are missing a person or you want to know what's happening in the person's life, you start looking at the Instagram account. If suppose your girlfriend has gone out with friends and she posts certain pictures and you try to call her up there and then, now she's in the middle of a event, whatever is happening, and she's just posted the pictures and you call and she doesn't take the call. It may leave you a little bitter. Oh, she's having fun, but not responding to me, right? Overusage of phone and overthinking can also do some damage to your relationship. So try not to do that. And the next point, show concern without expecting response. Again, to going back to that physical touch, or what the earlier point, do not spend too much time on the phone. If you have messaged or if you have called up and the opposite person, your boyfriend, did not take the call, definitely you feel, oh my God, see, I'm not important. That's the first thought can possibly come. If you can send some other message telling, how can I help you? I am missing you. I expected you to take the call. So whenever that person is in front of the phone, we'll look at it and reply. That's where trust plays a major role. Do not lose the trust in the relationship that you have. Stay committed. Now, how do you stay committed? By again showing your concern without expecting a response. If you think for some reason the other opposite person is stressed out with something or has long hours of work, cannot access the phone for whatever genuine reasons. You can definitely send a emoji or those gifs or memes telling that you are not alone, even though I'm so far, I'm still there for you. Here is a virtual hug. There are so many different ways to show your concern. And one more thing, as the festival season is coming along, you can definitely send so many gifts and, you know, home cooked food, those dry snacks. Nowadays in this electronic world, sending parcels are not that difficult, isn't it? They cannot send you, but you can send. And I think our India has a lot of resources in that manner, right? So there are so many possible ways to stay committed, to show your trust, to show your respect also. And it's all about emotions, right? So why not have communication which has emotions to talk along, rather than telling, why did you do this? That day I called you up, you didn't take the call. I had sent you 10 messages, not even one reply. I saw you read the messages, but you didn't respond. I saw the blue tick. How much time are you expressing your true emotion in that moment? Hardly any. You are just expressing your thoughts. Instead of that, you can say, I was worried. I was concerned because I saw the blue tick mark and you didn't reply. Wrong thoughts came to me, but at the same time, I thought maybe you are really busy. You didn't have time to read. Maybe you just click the conversation. There are so many positive ways to think the same thing. That can come only if you express your emotion. I know it can be very confusing, but work towards building your self-awareness. That can help you speak out your emotions, right? And at the same time, managing your emotions. If you are missing so much, you are worrying so much, tears may come out. First manage, then if you want, take a deep breath, have a glass of water, talk to a friend, go for an ice cream, then get back to the same conversation or talking or calling. You see, your words will be different. If you manage your emotion, you can manage the relationship better. Because that person is also very far. If you act out of panic, that person is also going to get doubly panic. It doesn't give a healthy outcome in a relationship, right? And when you talk, cherish those positive moments and the memories that you have. When you're alone, suppose the other person is not, the time zone also matters, right? There are different time zones. Here you are in a daytime and there it's a nighttime. You cannot call that very moment immediately. Instant gratification is not possible. But you do have, in today's technological world, there are so many pictures shared, so many short videos shared. You can cherish those moments. And if whenever you are calling up next, you can discuss about these moments. Hey, you sent that day short clipping about you were walking. Where were you going to? What happened? Whom did you meet? Have those before after conversations also. So that factor of what's happening in that person's life, or I'm not connected, that starts coming down. You start feeling present in that person's world. And that person also looks forward for this healthy communication, discussions, conversations, right? Emotional communication is the major key, right? And when we say emotional communications, you all know what is, if you are a Banjarite, you all know what is the spelling of communication. We in Banjara have a different spelling dictionary. For us, communication is listen. Yes, if you listen to a person, even if it seems boring to you, you are giving a soothing effect to the person who is speaking. Maybe he cannot speak to anybody and everybody what he's talking to you over the phone. It can be those difficult conversations at time. But remember the distance. Still he's made an attempt to speak. So you can imagine how much that person might be going through to take this opportunity to speak out. Just listen. Listening can be a very soothing time that you will be giving to your loved one. In a relationship, listening is also equally important. And while you are living apart, for whatever reason, it can be girlfriend, boyfriend, it can be husband and wife, right? For work reasons, you have to stay separate. But, or it can be a mother-daughter, mother-son, multiple relationships are there. Make concrete plans for the future. Now, when I say future, not only the long-term, those life kind of plans. But hey, when we meet next, maybe you don't even know when you will meet next. We will be doing this, we will be doing, start making those lists. It starts building hope and starts, you know, looking forward to kind of a scenario where once I meet next time, we are going to do this. Out of those list of 10, maybe you'll be able to do 5. So you have 5 more to carry forward, right? So like that, you can, you know, do a lot of things. And those lot of things can happen when you respect the relationship you are in. You trust, if you are a mother, I would say trust your upbringing. If you are a boyfriend, girlfriend, trust that you are made for each other. And, you know, this is a time which is tough for both of you, not only for the person who has gone or only for the person who is staying in. It's tough for both of you. But you will sail through. Give a hope to each other. Look forward to meeting as and when. And when you meet, make sure you talk about the present, not about what has been missed out. That otherwise also you communicate. Rather cherish the moment of togetherness, right? Work towards building your self-awareness. Work towards managing your emotions. And you will have a beautiful relationship, even if it is long distance. And we will break for a minute, and after that I would say start posting your questions and we will help you out in answering them.
Today, sharing a few thoughts about long distance relationship between mother and daughter. Yes, back in 2015, when my daughter had come to us and told us about her interest in a person, we were quite happy about the whole thing. But the moment I heard that he was a foreigner, a German, I just took back, and I was very worried that she will go away from me. I mean, she'll go away from India. So the first time when we met our son-in-law, my first request to him was that you please relocate to India and anywhere in India, and please don't take her away from here. And he just gave me a smile. He said, don't worry, everything will be all right. But it was just to console me. Of course, she got married and she went to Germany. And there were days when she would talk about adapting herself to the new place. And I would feel very helpless that I'm unable to be there for her. And I also felt the same thing, being a single child. You know, it was difficult to let her go. And, you know, the feelings, the touch, the hug, the kisses, like she would always make it up to me, even if we had a fight, you know, like she would just come and hug me, kiss me, and, you know, make all these kind of small, small things which would just melt me down. So those are things which I really miss. Even now, we have small little fights and arguments on video calls. But the difference now is that either she disconnects or I disconnect, and we go on sending emojis of hug, love, kisses, thanks to the technologies and communications through WhatsApp video. Yes, it's difficult to feel and you know, feel her and hug her, but I have to let her go, and I had to let her go for her good. And now she's settled with two children there, and we do have video calls with my grandchildren. So it's not very easy that we can go and visit them every now and then. We have to make our plans well in advance, and we cannot leave for so many, you know, days India and stay there. But whenever possible, she comes down or we go there. But again, it's the same thing when she goes back, the vacuum, the pain. It's very difficult. It's very difficult to handle these situations. But console myself with the new technologies through, you know, WhatsApp or Skype or whatever it is, we are still talking. But the personal touch makes a lot of difference. This was few of the things that I just wanted to share, but there are lots. Nothing can replace that, you know, physical being. Thank you.
So that is the heart of a mother, directly from her. This was, I must say that extempore. She's Indu Kamal. She's a director at the academics, and her daughter is abroad, and she has two beautiful grandsons, and she gets to speak to them, also teach them some Tamil over the phone, pora vara va po, something like that. You know, she keeps doing teaching them, which is a treat. Having said that, this was absolutely extempore, directly from her heart, and I think Indu really summarized the importance of trust, the importance of touch, and the trust that she had in her son-in-law, that this is how he is going to take care of her very well. So, and of course, communication. So Navyashri has mentioned that effective communication and communicating on a daily basis will improve any relationship. For any relationship to be successful, we have to exchange our thoughts to know if we are thinking the right direction. And to add on to that, Navyashri, I would like to add that it is important for us to express our feelings. It is important for us to work for things and not work against things.
So that is something which is really very important for us. And in communication comes dignity, speaking with respect, keeping in mind that this person is a significant person in my life, and hence I need to have respectful, dignified communication, be it a 2-year-old or an 82-year-old.
Yeah, and just to add on, to have that effective communication, if you have worked on, you know, managing your emotion, as I was telling, if you can have a social circle where you can, you know, go and speak and, you know, work towards finding out your peace in something on your daily basis, and then you communicate to the person who is so far away, I think your words will come out right.
Right, Purvi? Absolutely. I true that. And Navya also says that mobiles are being overused. It was use, misuse, and it's we have kind of, most of us have moved to abuse, because they say that if the first thing in the morning you want to have a look at the mobile and not tell a nice good morning and hug the persons in your family, means that mobile is more dearer to you than them. Well, that's on a lighter note, but yes, that is the level at which we are doing. And as Ali also did mention in his talk, that I have been a counselor for one of the branches of the Indian Army for nearly 5 years, and there they would play volleyball, handball, cricket, and they would all have a nice chat out in the park. Everything has got replaced with our little fellow who seems to be doing wonders to us. And the usage of mobile has to be very, very consciously curtailed. Navya again says that yes. I also feel that the money is playing a major role, that this Gen kids hardly cherish small things. If I may add that, I think it is also our responsibility as significant adults to ensure that all the small non-material things matter. If we can do that, Sonal deals that with children.
Includes, yeah, that includes giving them positive strokes for what they do. Okay, in not in a form of a star also, I would say, because many people think, okay, giving a star chart or a daily chart. So it's like, if I want to see whether my mama loves or no, I go and see whether I got a star or no. But my mama is sitting next to me. Can I go and hug her? Even if she is working in the kitchen or she is working on the laptop, can I just hold her legs and kiss to her level if your child's mouth is coming closer to your thighs, and if the child is just kissing over there? And however busy you are, if you are in a meeting or you are in the kitchen, just tapping the child's head also makes the child feel loved. If you do this small little gesture, you'll see that immediately the child starts running. Now, these are the things cannot be replaced with materialistic things, right? This is a practice which you have to start doing it.
In fact, Roshan says that every Sunday, our family, all in different places, make a conference call. Her son in US, other son in Nalagandla, and we in Secunderabad. We share what has happened during the week, and happy to see my children and grandchildren. Thanks to technology for making distant relationships so comforting. My mother, severely arthritic, would anxiously wait for her son's letters. And once after so many days, or would receive one letter, that would make her happy.
This reminds me of something. Yeah, as much as it helps everybody to connect on a WhatsApp, now I think you can connect 7 to 8 people at a time. But in that also, if you can, you know, bring in equality, respect to everybody who has joined in the call, give a chance for everybody to speak. Otherwise, the person who is talking the most is only talking away, and the other persons the silent ones are only listening. That is where I think you can use the technology wisely. Respect all the people who have made that effort to join the call, and give them also two chances to speak by asking them what's happening in their lives.
In fact, possibly just a suggestion which came to my mind when I was talking of aerograms and inland letters and things like that, that maybe it may be a good idea once in a while to say that this particular week no one calls, and everybody writes a letter to everyone else.
True.
Because earlier we would know the telephone numbers, the addresses by heart with the PIN code, which I'm sure now to a large extent, maybe we may not be, barring a few who really have good memories. So possibly have a happy thing that when you open your letterbox, you see only bills now. So open the letterbox and see the letters written by your loved ones and see how many of them take the initiative of actually penning down a few lines and sending it to you.
I think if we start practicing that, then hopefully post offices will not close down.
Yeah, I true that. Roshan says that though as friends we are far away, we are together as the minute why I close my eyes. Yes, that is the kind of friendship which we should surely have. That once you meet them, you take off from where you left and you don't feel the vacuum or the gap at all. Fantastic. Vinita says, I feel if we follow the basic norms of a relationship like trust, communication, respect, and commitment, of course, in the spouses, we can have a beautiful long distance relationship too. Thanks to technology that we can stay in touch with our loved ones.
Very true, Vinita.
Absolutely.
These four true. Pillars are important in relationships.
Yeah.
Trust, respect, communication and commitment.
Preeti says, this was the most awaited topic for me as my husband works in Dubai and travels on and off to Bangalore. It's been 6 years now. It has definitely been challenging to keep it going. Nevertheless, we have learned from experiences. Thank you for the presentation and we'll work on refining our way to keep the relationship stronger. Way to go, Preeti. The only thing is, I feel our daughter who is 7 years old, daughter, even though doesn't express herself about her father, I know she misses that touch, the presence of her father. In fact, Sonal deals a lot with children, so I'll ask, request her to address this.
Yeah, I would just share one of the experience of my sister's grandchild who is in the US, and we just do that little activity with her, telling that round around a garden, showing her on the hand, and then do this way to show that I'm tickling you, and you won't believe, she'll just start doing like this. So even if you're not actually touching, you can actually show the child that, you know, I am hugging you. Show those things. She will start feeling it. Your child will start feeling it. Talk about the touch. What happens when you touch? When you miss the touch, what happens? When you touch, what happens? What makes her feel secure? Make her talk about it. What are the insecurities what she may be possibly going through when she sees the other children having their fathers around? The more you make the child talk about the emotions and the feelings what she's experiencing, I think you will help her to deal with the present situation in a more healthier way and bring back the father's involvement in upbringing. Like, you know, as I was talking about telling stories, talking about the day, how it went, mutually, you tell, your child speaks, husband speaks, all of you speak. As I told on the screen, all of you get equal time to speak about yourselves. I think those things will slowly help. And if at all you think you need help, you can get back to us, to Banjara. As you all know, Banjara offers free counseling. Now, when we say counseling, doesn't mean only there has to be a problem. Sometimes you may even think that, okay, I want to talk to someone who will not going to judge me and I can just be myself. You can call up Banjara and we all are over here.
In fact, I just remembered there is a Marathi movie, okay? It's called Pimpal. Its pimple is a huge tree, right? So it is P-I-M-P-U-L. Otherwise, you will think it is pimple. So it is pimple. So that's a grandfather's story and his journey of life after his wife is no more. So he is, his grandchildren are in the US timing. So what he does is he'll sleep off early. And then when it is time for them, which is daytime, and the kids are available for the grandfather, he gets up, he'll, you know, ensure that he has, his hair is in place and he's combed it well and he looks fresh, and he will start his call every day in the evening. And he's, they're not talking of, you know, you should study or you should do this or like CID interrogating and all. nothing like that happens. He shares with them whatever wisdom he has. He shares with them some nice stories and, you know, some nice things. Maybe it might be about a flower or it might be about a plant. So the grandfather shares all those with the grandchildren on a day-to-day basis. So maybe if you are interested, you could, yeah, Anis has put up the name. It's a Marathi movie. Okay, not just a movie, a Marathi movie called Pimple. Maybe you may find it quite interesting to watch, and that also gives a little bit of inkling on the long distance relationships. Sharayu says that technology has shrunk the world and the human emotions too. Electronic connectivity helps in many ways, need to accept it. Yes, it has made the world a smaller place. But then I think there is just a slight difference between, as we keep, we have been talking about it, between a thin line. We do not know when we move from use to misuse to abuse. So I think that is something, as adults and as people who are aware of the importance of emotions, the importance of feelings, that we should try and avoid it. If not needed, let's not do it.
Yeah, in this world of technology, misuse of technology, there are so many online friendships happening without knowing the person's background. You see only what is shown to you. Yeah. But we start believing what is shown to you. Only later, if at all you meet, you see so many frauds happening. You see so many, you know, relationship developing and then feeling regret about it, right? So those are the things I think should be taken very seriously and taken care of before you step into such things, right? Because believing something which you don't know, you have never met physically, and just trusting and then committing to go and stay along with it and then going through, you don't know what all difficulties along with abuse. We have read in newspapers also.
And we do get a lot of people also for our coming.
Yeah.
I don't know if I should say we are fortunate or it is unfortunate, but we have had the opportunity of meeting people from the different strata of the society.
Yeah.
And that helps
us. In fact, last year one girl had come, she was in a relationship, an online friendship relationship. And she said that, you know, he sounds so genuine, he's so caring. And I'm planning to move out from the country to be with him. And I asked, where is he working? No, he has shown me the workplace. I said, on the video call? Yeah, he's shown me the shop where he's working. So can you just believe it? As we spoke ahead and ahead, she started thinking, no, I actually don't know the facts. I really need to rethink about it before I make a concrete decision. I'm telling you this in a very shortcut form, but it brought her to the awareness that I was getting carried away with whatever was shown to me. I really don't know the facts and I really need to find out. Whereas she was working towards quitting her job, going to the country, pack up everything and go. So imagine if she had gone there packing up everything, what all could have happened. Very recently she called up and said, Sonal, your conversation really helped me and I've decided I'm not going to go because I've understood that he's already married. What all he showed me was just to, you know, attract me or, you know, whatever was in his mind. But she is safe now and she is thinking for herself and she's going to be careful next time.
And in fact, I was just about to tell that Sonia, yes, good that you're reminiscing this happy moment. That we had an activity in Banjara, writing letter to one another on a particular day. So start doing that. Even if there are folks in your own house, sometimes it happens with these heavy schedules, which we have to understand. Children are not able to meet a dad as they would like to. Sometimes you don't have that much of a quality of time. But if you help children and if you yourself keep writing some small notes and, you know, push it under the pillow or keep it as they open their school diary calendar and they push it in, they will also learn to express, and of course going back to express your feelings. So Pushpa says that it's easy to to express your happiness when you are in long distance, but how do we deal with when you are frustrated or angry with that person? So I personally feel that if we have laid enough foundation, enough base in any relationship, then communication should actually not be an issue. And yes, sometimes we do feel that to show anger or to show frustration, what would be the impact of that on the other person, which I think even in person, it does happen sometimes. But then if you are a little assertive in your communication, Pushpa, you can cut across hypocrisy. You can cut across all the difficulties and challenges of communication. So,
and also when you're speaking about, you know, when you are angry with the other person, instead of using the word "you made me angry," you can say "I am feeling very frustrated." That using "I" word to express your emotions also brings down that, you know, bitterness in the other person, because it's your emotion.
It also shows that you are taking responsibility for your own communication. So even a word like "I think I'm seeming to be a little angry or a little disagreeing to this. Is it okay? I just have something immediately. Oh, I think somebody's at the door. Can we catch up later?" Doesn't matter. Nobody might be at the door, but "I think the milk is boiling. Can we just catch up in the next 5 minutes?" So you have those 5 minutes to calm yourself down, to get a little bit of a understanding of the situation, and then instead of reacting, responding. I think this, yes, to a large extent does hold good for long distance relationships, because you do not want to irk or irritate the other person. And then you may also feel that, you know, why should I do it? And then you are simmering over here, the other person is simmering over here. Have a good, proper, genuine, assertive communication. It can help you to a large extent to cut across. Because I think Ali also mentioned, so I'll just go back to that point, that 60% of close relationships survive the long distance phase. So while he told that 40% don't survive, I would say let's put ourselves in the 60% and make it 60 point something and help our relationships to survive, with the basis totally being on respect, communication. So in communication, you have assertive communication, you have dignified communication, respectful communication, maintaining the dignity of the other person, and speaking from a position of strength yourself. Yes. And of course, trust is absolutely there. Trust, respect, communication. I think to a large extent, we should be there. Yes.
And at times, you will have to show respect even if the other person is silent on the other side.
Yeah. So that's it. Is there anything else? Yes, you can drop in at Banjara. Reach us on the numbers. Anis has given you the numbers. We'll be absolutely delighted to have you all over with us. We do see you on Facebook, so maybe we can see it face to face, and nothing like it, right? So also upcoming are the next one is gratitude. I think a very important topic, how it enriches our life. I mean, from our counseling angle, I think the more we meet different kinds of people, it has been an unsaid blessing for us. Unsaid gratitude for us. It has enriched, enhanced, and made our own lives so much more meaningful, so much more content and happy with our family and so many people around us. So that is the topic coming up next.
I think this week you can start making a list of things you are feeling gratitude about.
Yeah.
And we can discuss the next week FB Live.
Yes, we'll do that. And the other topics are also put up. Problem solving, decision making, positive mental attitude. And like this, if you have any topics, do let us know next week. Bring out your list, and if we can slate in, schedule in anything, we'll be more than happy to do that. With this, Sonal and I, and with Ali in absentia, we sign off, and looking forward to a wonderful weekend, and wish you a wonderful one too. Thank you.